Some project specifications will require you to measure the adhesion of the coating system after it has been applied and is cured. Or you may be required to measure the adhesion of a coating system that has been on a structure for several years to determine its condition or whether it can be successfully overcoated. In either case, adhesion testing must be performed properly or you may obtain misleading results. When you perform an adhesion test, you are measuring the strength of a coating at several different planes in the system. First, you are testing the adhesion of the coating system to the substrate, or the adhesion of the coating layers to each other in a multicoat system. In both of these cases, you are testing the adhesion strength of a coating, or the bond of the layers to one another and to the substrate. When you perform an adhesion test, you are also testing the inner strength of each coating layer. This is known as cohesion strength of a coating, or the ability of each layer to hold itself together. The adhesion or cohesion of a coating system to a surface is highly variable and can be influenced by a multitude of factors. That is why there is no industry-wide standard that says that a certain type of coating must have a minimum adhesion or cohesion strength. However, project specifications may require a minimum adhesion value as contract requirement, and coating manufacturers will often report an adhesion value on their product data sheets. Sometimes this value is adopted into a project specification. Two types of adhesion can be assessed: shear and pull-off or tensile adhesion. Tape or knife adhesion is used to assess the shear strength of a coating system. Tensile machines are used to assess the pull-off adhesion. All of them can be conducted in the field or laboratory. Tape and knife adhesion do not require any special equipment and can be conducted rather quickly. The testing is addressed in ASTM D3359 and D6677. ASTM D3359 involves cutting an X or crosshatch pattern into the coating, applying a pressure-sensitive tape to the test area, and removing it. The amount of coating removed is rated according to an ASTM rating scale from 0 to 5, with 5 representing no coating being removed. ASTM D6677 involves cutting an X through the coating and probing at the cross section. The ease of removal is rated subjectively on a 0 to 10 scale, with 10 being no removal. Pull-off strength of coatings on steel is tested according to ASTM D4541. It requires the use of an instrument and the attachment of loading fixtures or pull stubs using an adhesive that may need to cure overnight up to 24 hours. A pull-off value is reported in PSI or KPA, and the location of break is reported as adhesion, cohesion, or glue. The approximate percentage of each type of break is also reported when there is a combination of locations of break. Similar types of equipment are used to evaluate the pull-off strength on concrete, but the loading fixtures are larger and the testing is conducted in accordance with ASTM D7234. As discussed, the test methods are used to evaluate two different adhesion properties. The tape and knife adhesion tests are used to evaluate the shear or peel strength of a coating, while the pull-off test is used to evaluate a coating's tensile strength or its resistance to a perpendicular pull. Since the testing mechanisms are different, peel back versus pull-off, the test results generated from each test are not comparable. That is, a high pull-off strength does not always equate to good shear or peel strength, and vice versa. Also, any type of adhesion test is destructive. That is, the coating in the area that the test was performed will be damaged, and oftentimes it must be repaired. Therefore, adhesion testing should not be conducted unless required by the project specification. The specification should also include repair procedures for the affected areas. That's all there is to it. Log on to ktauniversity.com for other instructional videos on adhesion and other subjects.